All right, so let's do this Black Order versus Black Order on a gigantic punch-up. About 90k here for me. This is the biggest Black Order in my arena shard. Putty NH with 6 reds on everybody and 7 on Thanos, so he's only missing 4 red stars out of 35 on this team, which is pretty phenomenal. As far as this goes, when you do positioning for Black Order, you really just want to make sure that Proxima and Corvus are at least 2 spots away from each other. That way, they both can't get blasted by the Thanos basic to start, because that more than often is what's going to cause those toons to go into the yellow, trigger the turn meter, and make you go first. So, at least with this setup, I can't get them both hit, but if one of them gets hit and then followed up with a Proxima special, then it potentially can knock him into the yellow. But what you're really trying to do is avoid getting either one of them in the yellow, or you want to get both of theirs in the yellow, and that's generally what I go for here. So you'll see he goes first, so he won the coin toss there. So he did hit my Corvus, that's fine. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to hit in the middle here and hit both Corvus and Proxima. They're both pretty beefy, so I'm not sure I'll be able to get both of them in the yellow, even if I get lucky here and hit both with the Proxima special. But I'm going to focus Proxima because that's what's most important. Getting her yellow, and see, it didn't quite get Corvus down there, unfortunately. But the thing is, my Corvus doesn't take a turn, so the bleeds don't really matter. That's why I like putting Proxima on the corner here, because it means she's less likely to get taken out. And now we're in a bit of a pickle here, because we got really low health on Thanos to start. And now we gotta hit this Corvus, and he's gonna get some turn meter off of that. Woof. Alright, so we'll do this, put offense down out there, hope that we can make it through a little bit longer. Did not resist the offense down, unfortunately, but that's how it goes. So we're gonna do basic, try to strip buffs from Cull. It's really tough, but you know, sometimes you get lucky. It just kind of depends. I'm actually focused on getting level 5 ISO Skirmisher on Maw and Proxima right now, because that will enable me to strip buffs off of Cull more likely, at least. All right, I have to use his ult here, even though he has the offense down, just to get health and hopefully kill out Maw. Got him. Oh, and I got Corvus too. So that's nice. So now we're up 5-3. That makes this pretty easy to finish up. Now, a lot of people go for the stun here. Yeah, I guess we could do that, but I don't know if it'll strip the buffs, because yeah, he has really good resistance. But at least he got the taunt, so that's a little bit of RNG there, is trying to get through that. You could also stun him if you wanted to, like she just stunned mine. I don't really care about stunning Cull. What I'm trying to do is get Proxima down right now, and so what I want to do is get rid of that D up, because really we're so far ahead right now. We should be fine. I can go ahead and stun him now. She's super fast, so you know, it happens a lot. So let's just kill Proxima with the AoE. Oh, didn't quite get her. That's okay. We're gonna go ahead and make him vulnerable, and then let's just take out Proxima now with the weak hit there. Let's get rid of that D up, and let's go for Thanos while he is stunned and slowed. That way he can't retaliate. So that makes this a lot easier. We'll put vulnerability back on him, and then we'll put offense down on both of them. And then, ooh, not quite there. Let's do the Corvus ult. Ah, oh, didn't quite get him. That special does a ton of damage, though. Let's go ahead and flip those buffs. That's always good. Ooh, didn't quite get it because the regens. He gets a ton of resistance when he has that regen up. But let's just go ahead and keep wailing on him. Should be a pretty easy win. But that's kind of the trick, really, is separating Proxima and Corvus so you have less chances of them getting one of those two into the yellow. I've never been able to get either Maw or Thanos or Cull into yellow on those first couple of turns, so I don't even bother with them. If they have Proxima and Corvus, you know, one spot away from each other, say they're in the back row each, you want to hit middle, hit both of them, get the bleeds on them from Thanos, and then focus Proxima with that special, unless she's already in the yellow. If she's a weak Proxima, she's already in yellow, you don't have to focus her with the special. You can hit Corvus instead. Because if you get both of them in the yellow, it's highly unlikely they're going to match that on your side, if you have the positioning I have, to get both Corvus and Proxima on the yellow. And that'll just determine who goes first with the flip. So if you can get them to flip first, then it's pretty simple. if you can't get them to flip first, then you're going to be playing catch up most of the match. But sometimes that kind of works to your advantage because you may get a bunch of turn meter by going second while you're trying to wait to use that flip on turn three of Thanos. It just kind of depends. You got to play it out a little bit. And of course, you know, every arena person I see has Black Order as their defense, so there's plenty of opportunity to test this and really refine your ability to punch up on these ones. But you can see there, that was almost a 90k punch up for me. That was just a breeze, right? If he had split up his Corvus and Proxima, though, a little bit more, I would have had a lot harder time with it. The thing is, Maw, Thanos, and Kull are the three most important, in my opinion, so you want to keep them separated a bit. However, like I said, I like Proxima on the one edge just to prevent her from getting that yellow health on the early damage, right? It's just less likely she's going to be hit. If you stick her in the back row or the middle, she's definitely going to get hit. She's going to get hit a lot, and you're going to be hoping that you win a coin toss of getting both Proximas into the yellow. And you don't want to be there. What you want to do is you try to control the fight as best you can. So putting her on one of the ends will make it a lot easier to do that. Other than that, it's really just a matter of playing it through and then also being smart about who you hit into the yellow as you go. Now, if you kind of steamroll the enemy really fast and say you clear out Maw, Corvus, and Proxima, or get them all down to less than half health, you can sometimes run into a situation where Thanos is using his ult before you even get your third turn with your Thanos. And if you don't have offense down on him, it can be really costly. It can do a lot of damage to you. So you just kind of need to pick your battles. Make sure, you know, if you need to focus just one character and you don't want to hit the adjacent characters, like with Proxima and Corvus, just use their basic, right? You'll dispel some buffs, you'll do a bunch of damage. And as long as you have the setup where you got one of them Striker and one of them Skirmisher, you'll get that triple tap, you know, one hits first, the other one assists, applies vulnerability, and then the other one comes back and follows it up with an ISO 8 attack. That is just key to the Black Order fight. So if we ever get the chance to be able to set ISOs on defense in arena and lock it, I will definitely be putting Protector on Proxima, though, because she is the key to this fight. If you can get her at a high level Protector, oh man, that really changes this fight by getting a whole bunch of barrier on her, because that just means they got to do more damage to get her into yellow. And so I think that's one key, but I'm not willing to leave that on her constantly just for arena defense, because I use her, you know, I use Black Order all the time, so I don't want to mess with that. But if we do get that chance, I will be making that change. So anyway, that's how I fight Black Order pretty much constantly. Focus Proxima, try to get Corvus down as well if he's adjacent or really close to her, and then just focus the squishies and leave Thanos and Maw for last, or Thanos and Kull for last, because those two are going to take the longest. They always have the most health, and that's just outruns. But that's it. That's the whole fight in a nutshell. It's pretty simple and straightforward. I just got to practice a bit, get used to different configurations for defensive lineups, and you should be able to take them out easily every time, even with big punch-ups like that.